My grandfather's problem-solving paradigm was predetermined. He was a lawyer, he knew the answer, he would walk in and tell them what happened before. My father's paradigm of problem-solving was deterministic. Something works, scale it through process and technology. My paradigm is what is probable. Many of us kind of guess and take decisions on what we think will happen. Our children's paradigm of problem solving is going to be improbable. The ability to come up with improbable answers, what is also called emergent behavior, behavior you didn't plan for, I think is going to be important. So I think when you say you have free spirit, you have unexpected behavior from children, I think in some ways you may be preparing them for a world that will require that. So predetermined answers, deterministic answers, probable answers, they are all time for that is over. I think it's time for improbable answers.
muPathshala, a unique experiment in learning developed by muSigma, piloted at Inventure Academy. Grades 9 to 11 worked in groups on solving business problems using data analytics with facilitation from muSigma mentors.
I wanted to set up an education institution which would enable children to be able to ask the right questions, not just know the right answers to questions that they already were told would come for the exam. I wanted to teach students to be able to identify and solve problems and really to have a more entrepreneurial approach to life. And which is why when we got that email, we were very happy to grab it, because we've been doing a lot of things here at Inventure in terms of our theme-based learning, in terms of the celebration of learning, which is based on project work, our youth parliament program, our change maker program, our pods. All of these are designed to teach children about life. But what seemed very obvious is that you all had invested a lot of time in thinking through what young graduates required. So really for us, it was a no-brainer.
Irrespective of what job your child will do eventually, whether they're going to be a doctor or a scientist or a pricing leader or a marketing executive, I think every job in the future will involve analytics and algorithms in some form or the other. We do not believe that analytics is a separate job in itself. It is going to be embedded in all of our jobs, which is why I think this is interesting. We're not trying to turn your children into analytics professionals. We're trying to turn them into a better artist, a better investor, or a better entrepreneur.
For example, the problems we gave were things like, what if ATMs are running out of cash? What if you had to change the literacy of women in a country? Or if you were a company predicting the next big hit, what would you do?
muSigma is a company that is very versatile, and they've asked a lot of important questions to us. I've never seen problem solving take this kind of a direction, because it was given such a structured way of going about. Normally when you get a problem, it's an individual's way of solving it, but through this program we learned a process to find out our answer.
First principle thinking is when you come from a space of making no assumptions, you're coming from a space where you're not taking anything for granted, and you're going to question everything. You're going to question the why of everything. You're going to question, why is this important? How can I solve this? And you're not going to think of anything that's not unrelated. You're going to take everything into the picture and then try to solve the problem.
Having that spark ignite is something that they should really, really focus on, because this is something that can help them ignite that spark. You should really not let that go.
I think it's cool that they're trying to teach us different ways of thinking to solve the problems, so that we can, when we go out into the world, like right now we have to do our internships and stuff, so it's showing us different ways to think so that we don't stay in the box.
What I want them to take away would be, I think one main thing is how to have a learning over knowing mindset. Always be open to learn more rather than have the same sort of information, the same sort of knowledge being carried on throughout your life. So that mindset really helps you adapt to anything, any challenges that are put across to you.
There was a quote that I read on the muSigma wall. It said, it was by Albert Einstein. He said that if he had 1 hour to save the world, he would spend the first 55 minutes of it defining the problem. And that was something that really resonated, because all of us, when we come across a problem, we usually think about the solution and we always are driven by the solution. But what we should really be focusing on is the problem.
Being teenagers, like, I know it. I know how to solve this. I know the answers. Don't jump to it. Data often surprises you. And I hope these kids, who whatever data problem they have been given, have been surprised by the data.
I thought that two different variables, they would have an expected kind of a plot, but the data provided us something completely different. I realized how you need data everywhere, because if you're just making assumptions, you're never going to come to the right conclusion. And that's really important, because if you don't have the correct approach to a problem, you won't solve the problem. And if you don't solve the problem right, other problems can arise. And I think that was the most important and like aha moment for me.
I'm really thinking as an educator, what do I need to do to prepare my children more effectively for this world? And two, what's going to happen in terms of jobs which are actually done by human beings right now? Like understand a person's emotion. And what's going to happen to everybody who's not actually going to be able to get a job in this world?
One narrative popularized by technology companies is that algorithms will take over the world and make decisions for us. I don't subscribe to that point of view. I truly think that algorithms will run amok if you don't have human intuition and human participation in them.
I think the experience itself is so like not something that everyone would get to experience, especially just sitting in a class, you can't really learn these things. So I think it's really helpful to know how real life is going to be, how working with like many different people and learning how to interact with everything.
Be part of the of a working day, to experience this kind of problem solving, to work with people who have been doing it for some time, and to understand that that there is potential for everybody, that it's not. Sometimes, students get kind of bogged down by thinking, oh my God, these are things that are so difficult for us. And I think you also work with that mindset and show that you're always maximizing potential and possibilities. And you never know what will click for a child. And you want to create those moments.
Every time we teach something new in class, the kids always ask us that, where am I going to use this? I think I found a lot of answers to this, so that was the best takeaway for me. I think that a lot of students are able to draw those connections and connect the dots.
In the field of analytics, one of the things that we learn is asking the right questions and asking enough questions, because it's just data points that you collect, and you guys are really good at that, so make sure you continue to do that. And the energy that you bring, right, it's infectious, right? It motivates us, helps us, and it's brilliant working with you guys. So just never lose that when you grow up.
What I've learned is you need a really bigger deal of clarity to be able to interact with kids. What you talk around with your clients and with your peers is something very different, and you can just get around with just throwing some buzzwords here and there, but with kids you really need to know the concept, and that is what the preparation that came into came along with this has made me realize how to be that person and be that person with extra clarity.
One thing that comes in the way for solving problems differently is fear. As you get older, as you learn a lot, as you have a lot of knowledge, that baggage comes in the way. You are also either in the past of things that you achieved or the future of where you want to get to. You are rarely in the moment. I think children are in the moment. We want our teams to rediscover that child in them and appreciate what it is to be in the moment, and also get them to see what it is to think first principles. So I think it's as much of a learning for our teams as it is for these children. So we are super excited.